Let's get right to Alabama's senior Republican Senator Richard Shelby, who joins us now from Tuscaloosa. Senator, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it. You said that you already cast your ballot in the Alabama special election and that you chose to write in a candidate instead of voting for the Republican Roy Moore. The latest polls are neck and neck, showing Jones, the Democrat, leading by a hair. Perhaps when it comes down to it on Tuesday, who would you rather see win?
Well, I'd rather see the Republican win, but I'd hope that Republican would be a write-in. I couldn't vote for Roy Moore. I didn't vote for Roy Moore, but I wrote in a distinguished Republican name, and I think a lot of people could do that. Will they do it? I'm not sure. I don't know what's going to happen. You know, as a Republican, I had to vote Republican. I wanted to vote Republican. I understand where the president's coming from. I understand we would like to retain that seat in the U.S. Senate. But I tell you what, there's a time, we call it a tipping point. And I think so many accusations, so many cuts, so many drip, drip, drip. When it got to the 14-year-old story, that was enough for me. I said, I can't vote for Roy Moore.
But you're going to wake up on Wednesday, and one of these two men, Roy Moore or Doug Jones, is going to be your fellow senator from Alabama. Which one would you rather deal with on a professional level?
Well, I don't have to answer that question today. I had rather see another Republican in there, and I'm going to stay with that story. I'm not going to vote for the Democrat. I didn't vote for the Democrat or advocate for the Democrat, but I couldn't vote for Roy Moore. The state of Alabama deserves better. I think we've got a lot of great Republicans that could have won and carried the state beautifully and served in the Senate honorably.
Will you tell us who you voted for, who you wrote in?
I am not going to tell you that any more than you do, okay?
Well, let me ask you. Roy Moore's accusers include Lee Korfman, who alleges that he sexually molested her when she was 14, and Beverly Nelson, who alleges he sexually assaulted her when she was 16. Do you believe these two Alabama women?
I think the women are believable. I have no reason not to believe them, just like the Attorney General Sessions said he had no reason or something not to believe the women. They were credible. But, you know, I wasn't there. I don't know what happened, but there's a lot of stories there. There's a lot of smoke. Got to be some fire somewhere.
Your fellow Republican Senator Cory Gardner of Colorado, who's head of the Senate Republican campaign arm, the NRSC, he is calling for Roy Moore to be expelled if he wins the election on Tuesday. Back in November, Gardner said in a statement, quote, "If Moore refuses to withdraw and wins, the Senate should vote to expel him because he does not meet the ethical and moral requirements of the United States Senate." Do you agree?
Well, if he wins on Tuesday, the Senate, under the Powell case out of the Supreme Court, will have to seat him, and we'll see what happens after that. But I want to reiterate again, I didn't vote for Roy Moore. I wouldn't vote for Roy Moore. I think the Republican Party can do better.
Would it be appropriate for the Senate to launch an ethics committee investigation if he wins?
Well, I understand that's already being contemplated, but that would be up to the leadership and others to do that. I think that the Senate has to look at who's fit to serve in the Senate.
President Trump obviously is all in on Roy Moore. He recorded a robocall for him. He had a rally in Pensacola, Florida, just across the state line on Friday, where he urged his supporters to vote for Moore while also condemning his opponent, Democrat Doug Jones. Take a listen to the president.
He will never, ever vote for us. We need somebody in that Senate seat who will vote for our Make America Great Again agenda.
So get out and vote for Roy Moore.
Do it. Do it.
If Roy Moore wins on Tuesday, I think it's fair to say that it will be because President Trump supported him. Do you wish President Trump had not provided cover for Roy Moore, that he'd stayed out of the race?
I think Roy Moore has his own following, regardless of whether the president's involved or others. I don't know what's going to happen Tuesday. It depends on the turnout and go from there. But I do believe, and I'm going to say it again, the Republicans could do better.
Your Democratic colleague Al Franken resigned from the Senate on Thursday after a wave of allegations of sexual harassment against him. Take a listen to what he said in his resignation speech.
I, of all people, am aware that there is some irony in the fact that I am leaving while a man who has bragged on tape about his history of sexual assault sits in the Oval Office, and a man who has repeatedly preyed on young girls campaigns for the Senate with the full support of his party.
Do the Democrats have a higher standard for a code of, for behavior and conduct than the Republicans do?
Absolutely not, and I think you'll see all this play out. I believe whether you're a Republican, a Democrat, independent, whatever you are, you would not put up with the conduct, bad conduct from a Democrat or a Republican, and that's going to be part of the what's going to happen in the future. The Senate's going to have to weigh if Roy Moore wins his fitness to serve in the U.S. Senate.
And let's turn to the economy. Obviously, right now, taxes, the tax bill is in conference committee or is about to enter conference committee. Take a listen to something President Trump said on Friday.
Economic growth last quarter surged to 3.3%. The stock market is hitting an all-time high record for another, and think of this, 86 times since Election Day.
As the president just noted, the economy is doing quite well in many respects. Democrats say, why do you need to give a tax cut to big businesses and the wealthy if the economy is doing so well? What do you say to them?
Well, first of all, I don't believe that tax bill is just for a few people. It's for a lot. It's a lot of relief for a lot of the working people, middle class. It's probably something for just about everybody in the bill. That's how legislation comes about. I plan to support the bill when it comes out of the conference committee. I voted for it before. I think it's a step in the right direction.
He says it's going to boost the economy, though, and I guess the question is, does the economy even need boosting?
Well, the economy's good now, but it could be better. There's probably $5 trillion lying around in savings accounts and bank accounts in this country that looking for better investment. We can grow this economy more. We have to prove that we can, and I believe we will.